So after finishing editing these photos in Photoshop, I discovered a feature in Evoto that could have made the entire retouching process way much quicker than when I did it in Photoshop. And I just thought I should share it with you guys. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So I'm now in Evoto. Let me just zoom in a little bit. So in these photos, my model's hair played a very important role. So I retouched it just a little bit. So let me show you the easiest method I discovered to retouch the hair in Evoto, and then I'm going to show you the not so easy way I did it in Photoshop. So let me just go on this icon, the portrait retouching. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to go down, just down here on hair. I'm going to open this folder, and then I'm going to go down here. So we have remove stray hair slider here. So I'm going to, let me just zoom in this side so that we can see what's happening here. I'm going to take this slider all the way to 100% like this. And let me just zoom out a little bit. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me zoom in. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So the stray hairs are now gone. So we have two sliders here. So we have within figure outline. If I take it to zero like this, let me just zoom in a little bit. So I'm bringing back the hair inside here. So this is the before, this is the after. It's not doing anything, but if I take it to 100% like this, this is the before, this is the after. The stray hairs are gone inside here. They are gone. This is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom out a little bit. And then when I go down here, we have the beyond figure outlines. So if I take this all the way to zero, I'm bringing back the stray hairs here. This is the before, this is the after, but only the stray hairs inside are gone. This is the before, this is the after, but the outside is still there. This is the before, this is the after. So if I want to balance this, I can just maybe take this somewhere maybe to 80%, 70%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So I'm going to take it to 100% like this. Then I'm going to zoom out a little bit like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So there's so many things you can do in Evoto, but this is the one I wanted to show you. So Evoto is free to use all features. You only be charged one credit to export one image. So if you download Evoto using the first link in the video description below, you get 30 free credits to export 30 free images. So now let me show you the not so easy approach, the one I did in Photoshop, so that you can see how easy it is doing it in Evoto. I wish I knew this before I started retouching these photos in Photoshop. So let me just go in Photoshop. I'm now in Photoshop. Let me just zoom in like this. There are so many ways you can do it, but this is how I did it. So let me just go to my tools here. And then if I want, I can use the spot healing brush or the healing brush or the patch tool. Let me show you how to do this using the patch tool. I'm going to zoom in a little bit like this, and then I'm going to select this like this, and then I'm going to move it like that. Then I'm going to select this, and then I'll move it like that. I'm going to select this, and then I'll move it like that. Now imagine I'm working on maybe 50 images with the same process. It's going to take a lot of time. So I'm going to undo this, Control or Command Z on the keyboard to undo everything that I did here. Let me show another method. So I'm going to go to my tools here. Then I'm going to select the clone stamp tool here. Let me just zoom in a little bit. So with the clone stamp tool, I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to hold alternate on Windows or option on Mac. And then I'm going to left click to sample a clean part. And then I'll just paint on this like that. Alternate, left click, and then paint. Alternate, left click, and then paint like this. So keep doing this. So this is going to take a lot of time for me to just finish doing this. So I'm now in Evoto. So let's proceed with the retouching, right? So I'm going to go on this icon here, portrait retouching. I'm going to click on it. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to show you how you can use these powerful sliders to retouch your photos. I'm going to go to this side. Let me just move this slider and see what's going to happen. So I'm going to move it like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me zoom out a little bit like this. Okay, so let's remove the body blemishes by taking it all the way to 100. I'm going to remove the face shine. Let me just take this slider this side like this. You see, so this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So I'm going to undo this by double clicking on this circle here. Let's move to the forehead wrinkles. Even though she doesn't have the wrinkles, let's just move this slider and see what's going to happen, like that. So nothing is happening. Let me just move to the eye wrinkles. Let me just take it to 100%. Okay, so we can see what's happening here. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, let me just zoom out a little bit. Let's move this side. Dark circles, let me just take it to 100%. The dark circles are gone here. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, let's move to the smile lines. Let me take it to 100%. Smile lines are gone. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me just move it here. Let's try to remove these lines here, neck lines. Let me just go to the neck wrinkles here. Let me take it to 100%. The neck lines or neck wrinkles are gone. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom out a little bit like this. So I'm going to go to the double chin here. I'm just going to take it to 100%. Let me just zoom in. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So you can see what's happening here. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So we are done with the blemish removal. Let me just close this. Let's move to the skin retouching here. I'm going to move the dodge and burn slider this side. I want to take it to maybe 90%. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, I'm going to move to the skin smoothening. Let me just take it to 100% like that. So the skin is too smooth. Let me just reduce it a little bit to maybe 35%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, so let's move to body smoothening. Then if I take it to 100%, it's making the body smooth. If I take it all the way, only this part is now smooth. I'm going to take it to maybe 30%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, let's move to the background icon here. So I'm just going to try to select the black background, maybe the fabric. Let's see, more here. We have more colors. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So let me just check this icon here. Let's see if it's going to fix anything here. The wrinkles are gone from my model's outfit. This is the before, this is the after. Let me just take it to maybe 60%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Okay, so what I can do now, I can save all the adjustments that I did to this image. I can just go on save presets here, and then I can just rename it to maybe Evoto, and then group, can just name it maybe Ike, and then save, and then I'm just going to click on save here. Okay, so now my preset is saved. So now let me show you what I can do with my preset. So I can select one of these images. Let me just select this one, and then let me just go to my presets here, and then I'm going to select my presets here, and then I'm going to click on this group, and then I'm going to select this preset here. It's going to do everything that I did on this image. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So if you want to try Evoto AI, I'll put the link in the video description below where you can download this software. If you want to see how I shot these images, you should check this video here.